Knowing the do's and don'ts of washing your clothes can be a difficult affair when looking at the tag, especially when it comes to shrinking. But what is it exactly about different materials that makes some safe to wash at home and others dry clean only? When you get down to it, folks, this is a quick lesson in material chemistry, one that will give you the scientific know-how to stop yourself from destroying your favorite ensemble. First, you need to understand the materials that your clothes are made out of. We can break clothing fibers down into three categories: synthetic, plant-based, and animal-based. Each of these types of fibers have a chemical makeup that will respond to cleaning methods differently, and many clothing garments can be made out of a mix, so knowing how they interact with water is key here, folks. Synthetic fibers are polymer chains built out of small units, or monomers, that are usually derived from petroleum. These include materials like polyester, nylon, polypropylene, and many more. Most synthetic fibers are hydrophobic or water-hating, which is why they're often used as outerwear to shed water or underwear to breathe and let moisture escape from the skin. For the most part, these types of materials have no issue with water and don't really shrink when machine washed. Second, we have plant-derived materials like cotton, linen, and hemp that have fibers with chemical structures made of cellulose, which are long polymers of glucose molecules. These types of materials are perfectly fine to clean in the washer at home because the cellulose fibers are polar and therefore hydrophilic or water-loving. This quality allows these types of materials to absorb and release water without any lasting effect on their structure. Be careful though, because high temperatures both with washing and drying can potentially warp these materials, but for this reason many clothing manufacturers pre-shrink thread so you don't have to worry about it. Protein-based fibers like silk and wool are a totally different story. These materials have polar and nonpolar sections arranged in tube-like structures which make the inside hydrophilic, but the outside hydrophobic. These exteriors are excellent for light exposure to water, like when it rains, because it rolls right off. But when things really get wet, your garment is in big trouble, because water can eventually break through into the hydrophilic interior, where it sticks around. This is why wool takes so long to dry once it gets fully soaked. These water molecules cause the interior of the fiber structure to swell, and to accommodate that swelling, the exterior of the fiber has to contract lengthwise. When the water eventually evaporates, the fibers remain in the shortened configuration, and your favorite sweater is now misshapen or way too small. There's a couple ways to get around this. You can buy specially treated wool, or wool blended with synthetic fibers specifically designed to withstand cleaning in a washer. However, if you do have untreated wool, wash it by hand with wool-friendly detergent. Regular detergent interacts with the hydrophobic surface, helping transport water into it, causing damage to its structure. A low temperature, short wash time, and a mild detergent all help to reduce stress on fibers to limit damage. Just make sure to reshape your clothes when you lay them out to dry, or the wool may dry misshapen. And then there's dry cleaning, which saves your clothes from any contact with water. When looking at the label, if you read dry clean, it's actually more of a recommendation than a necessity. It's when it says dry clean only that you should do so, because these are the clothes that are prone to shrinkage. Contrary to what you might think, dry cleaning isn't dry at all. Instead of using water, this method of cleaning relies on chemicals like perchloroethylene, or PERC for short. This chlorinated molecule can't penetrate protein-based fibers, so it doesn't cause any shrinkage. When you bring your clothes to the cleaners, they're cleaned with a mixture of PERC and detergent, both of which have specific purposes. PERC is an oil-loving, nonpolar solvent, so it does a great job of lifting nonpolar stains from the fabric, like that sweat ring around your collar, or that greasy spill from lunch. The detergent, on the other hand, helps lift any water-soluble stains that the PERC can't interact with. After a final PERC rinse, the laundry gets spun and tumbled dry, all within the same machine. But a word of caution, some synthetic fibers can actually dissolve in dry cleaning solvents, so if you see this symbol, believe it. By keeping your eyes on the materials that your clothes are made of, you're also keeping an eye on their unique chemical interactions. Plants and synthetics are good to go in water, but protein-based animal fibers will always need some special attention, and maybe even the dry cleaners. Yet another reason to keep your chemical knowledge fresh and clean. If you have any other household chemistry questions you want answered, let us know down in the comments. Any other laundry life hacks or tips to share, post them down there as well, and we will see you again soon.